dad of our next guest artist who's coming up right now. Her name is Joey Misailidis. And she's going to have with her, let's see, a backup of about 10 to a dozen young men and women from Chiefess Kamakahelei Middle School. Just sitting right over here. Come on. Come up to the stage, Joey. Let's see, 2, 4, 6. Oh, we have 6, 7. We have one girl, okay. Schools, elementary schools, high schools, middle schools. We try to get out into the community to reach the young people because, you know, it's the young people who, believe it or not, many of them have not been exposed to the Hawaiian music that we consider as beauty, as Hawaiian music, I should say. The music of yesterday, the traditional Hawaiian music, as well as the steel guitar. And so, what we've been doing in planting seeds is we're seeing some of these seeds grow into little plants, and in some cases they're growing into something taller than them. And I mean, there's some young people who have since on neighbor islands started playing the Hawaiian steel guitar. And so we have these young people over here. Oh, by the way, this is a school that we visited last year, and I was surprised to find out when I went there to visit them yesterday that their teacher, Mr. Gonzalez over here, Elias Gonzalez, he actually purchased 3 steel guitars for his students. Why? Because they sound so good. They sound really sweet. You want to know something about steel guitars too? The most inexpensive steel guitar you can find online is $99. And those are the ones that my beginner students use. Later on, when they get better and better, they upgrade. Like Alexis, if you look at her steel guitar, she has a frying pan. She started on the little one. And then she graduated, she went from that to another steel guitar, to another steel guitar, and now another steel guitar. So these young ones, what happens is as they get better, the upgrade, like, show your steel guitar to everybody. This is Joey, that is not the steel guitar she started with. She started on the little $99 one, and she got another one, and then somebody, donated a steel guitar to her. Somebody from San Francisco said, wow, she's doing so good. I want to give her one of my steel guitars for my collection. And this is a beauty. Show them one more time. Look at this. Look how beautiful that looks. You can't see it yet. There, now you can see it. So yes, we do also take donations of steel guitars. And as young ones, you know, are ready to upgrade, then we pass it on. Yes, Julie. We take financial donations, absolutely. The donations, any donations, financial donations, helps us to put on these concerts free of charge, open to the public, as well as helps us, enables us to go to different schools and to plant seeds, to introduce Hawaiian music and the steel guitar. And then, of course, I always like to take my young ones with me, because I tell you what, they connect very well with the young ones in the schools. And not only that, they are so good, they're so fabulous that there are others that look up to them and say, I want to be just like that. I want to be just like him, I want to be like her. So it's a positive thing, you know, we got to get kids off the streets, we got to get them on instruments or doing something that is positive. And I tell you what, if they play the steel guitar, it's going to be all positive, because only beautiful music comes out of this instrument. Beautiful music. Okay. Okay, right now, this person I'd like to introduce, wait, is that stand too high? I can't see you. She's shy, by the way. This is Joey's sister playing the U bass, and you gotta listen to that bass, how she plays that instrument. And her name is Tai Misailidis. Say hello, Tai. Okay, and then we have, let's see, let me introduce the instructor to this group once again. This is Elias Gonzalez of Chiefess Kamakahelei. Oh, yes, absolutely.
Good morning. I'd like to introduce my students, and I'm so proud that you're able to join us today. My group is composed of almost 200 students, and unfortunately, I couldn't get a lot of them here today. There is a band solo ensemble taking place at school at this moment, and a lot of them are in chorus and in band. So I feel like it's very important that they get the opportunity to do the solo ensemble. And of course, for these students here, I'm very proud that they are here and able to join us. We have two, let me introduce the students. We have Sophia. We have Matthew. Let me introduce my two singers over here. They're going to join us on our last two songs. Okay, we have Max. Max, would you stand? Stand. And Todd. Todd, please stand. And I want to introduce two special guests of mine. They are no longer my students. I wish they were. I had them last year. They're now freshmen at Kaua'i High. And we have Dallas. And Adrian. They were with us last year and were able to participate. And I was able to get a hold of them and ask them for a return. Yes. So, okay. This is our group.
Okay.
Thank you.
Mahalo. And then let me introduce our guest artist over here. She's in the seventh grade at Punahou School. And she is, how old are you now? 11, 12, 13, 12. Okay. Can't keep up with other young ones in Te Kula Mele. But well, one thing before I introduce her, since Julie asked this question, I believe donations can be made directly online to www.haimele.org/donate. Again, that's www.haimele.org/donate. Okay? And we would appreciate anything. I mean, $1 million would be appreciated. Yay! Boy, we could go to every island, including the little rocks up and put that money. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Joey Misailidis.
Ship, and the song is in Thank you. Thank you.
So, still guitars. Somebody was asking me again about donating, to High Melon. Yes, you can. I had mentioned earlier, www.highmelon.org/donate. Or you could always go over to the store and you see that pretty lady up there? Actually, there's two of them. There's Mrs. Sardina. Mrs. Sardina, raise your hand. Sandy Sardina. She'll collect. If anybody wants to donate, she'll take down your information and so on. And of course, there's Andrea Tolentino, who's the mom of Alexis Tolentino. So, if you want to, we would appreciate anything. Now, the next person who's going to come up to the stage is a gentleman all the way from DeKalb, Illinois. He's been playing music ever since he was a young man. I think 8 years old, somewhere around there. 4 years old, yikes. Really, 4 years old. And now that he is 14, 10 years later, 15, okay, you went, okay. So anyway, he started playing the steel guitar, the lap steel, way back in, I think, 1972, somewhere around there. Actually, this is what I know about Dave. He's been playing bluegrass for about 40-somewhat years. And it was just about it, not too long ago, that he started playing the Hawaiian style steel guitar, which he loves to do because he comes to all of our festivals.